Good afternoon and welcome to Content, Commerce, and Direct Connections. I'm Jim Norton. I'm Chief Revenue Officer at Flowcode, a next generation QR technology platform. And I'm delighted to be joined by two legends of the industry, both Kristen O'Hara, Chief Business Officer at Hearst Magazines, and Daz McColl, Chief Marketing Officer at Neiman Marcus. Good afternoon, guys.
Hi there.
Hi, Jim.
Thanks for joining. Exciting conversation that we have. And I think it goes without saying, two legendary heritage brands, both brands over 100 years old. And that's something that I definitely want to touch on today as we think about innovation and innovation amongst heritage brands. So I'd just love to start off, Kristen, if you wouldn't mind talking a little bit about how Hearst Magazines is thinking about innovation within your business.
Sure. And Jim, I think in a secret life, you could have been a radio announcer with that sort of introduction. And Daz, it's so nice to see you. So thanks for joining too. I would say, you know, for me, when I think about innovation, I think we need to take a systemic view of innovation within organizations. And a lot of times we confuse kind of ideas and brainstorming with building truly an innovative culture within organizations. And, you know, it's more about the mindset than the action or the idea. And I would say that that sort of innovation mindset is perhaps even more important, if not as important, for 100-year-old companies like a Neiman Marcus or a Hearst, right, than it is a Flowcode. I think you shared the other day, Jim, what Flowcode is too.
Maybe. 2 years old, yeah. So we're a little behind you.
Yeah, exactly. So I really think it's about a hypothesis-driven culture, right? Where you build an organization that is willing to kind of test and learn and test and fail. And not everything you try is going to lead to the promised land, but you can learn from everything you do. You know, as the saying goes, you have to kiss a few frogs, right, before you find the prince. I think the other part for me is you also need, you know, this world is moving so fast and no one can really go it alone these days. And so, you know, we talk a lot at Hearst about, you know, you have to be a great partner to bring out the best in your partners. And your partners are going to be the ones who can kind of help be an accelerant, right, for innovation and change and growth in your organization. And building that culture of really, it's not a zero-sum game. It really is, how do you create partnerships that are truly beneficial, where you both build each other's businesses while you can learn at the same time? So that's a little bit about kind of how I think about it and how we're kind of working at Hearst.
Terrific. And Daz, just as a retailer and, you know, the consumer landscape continues to evolve rapidly, how do you and the team at Neiman Marcus think about innovation?
I think there's two big dimensions that I like to focus on. One is really understanding the customer. And if we're innovating for innovation's sake, we're wasting a lot of time and effort. We may learn a few things, but we're probably not going to learn the right things. So to me, really having a good, clear perspective on the customer and the role we want to achieve for our business strategy. And to Kristen's point, partnership's the other one. You know, you can't do anything that's from a marketing innovation perspective, I believe, that doesn't connect across some forms of platforms, because that's where we connect with our customers. And, you know, I can pleasingly say that, you know, the partnership we have with Hearst that we've been building for not that long, but it's been growing fast, is built on trust. And it means we can try a few things. And if they don't work, we're not going to walk away from each other. We're going to find ways to do it better the next time. And I think that gives you the right spirit of innovation as well.
Yes. And speaking of trying a few things, there's a great partnership that you both are testing right now with Flowcode. And so utilizing Flowcodes to enable Shop Bazaar, and so those Hearst consumers, to connect directly with the Neiman Marcus brand. Kristen, can you just talk a little bit about how you and the team think about that and using a tool like Flowcode to create those direct connections?
Sure. Well, I think, you know, it goes back to kind of, I guess, what Daz and I both touch on, which is, you know, partners can help you think differently, right, about how you chart the path to the future. And so, Jim, you and I know each other from a past life. We got connected, right? You shared the kind of Flowcode technology, which made innate sense to us, right? To take something like print, right? And how do you make print really actionable, shoppable, et cetera? In Daz, we have a partner who, you know, we've been working together, and I think Daz and I share a lot of the same viewpoints about this whole content to commerce connection. And that when consumers are inspired in a content environment, regardless of what medium that's in, we don't want to disrupt that. We want to pull them further along on the customer journey. And so when we thought about kind of the fall fashion work that Neiman was looking to do, you know, Shop Bazaar is our first luxury marketplace at Hearst. And the opportunity to create a highly curated experience of Neiman Marcus products with their designers and our editors, create a ton of content around that, and have Flowcode be a piece of technology, you know. And I remember when we first talked about it, it's like the QR code had its renaissance in some ways during COVID and restaurants, and we all got so comfortable with it. But as consumers kind of experience the print environment, the ability to click on a Flowcode and go with a Neiman Marcus kind of Shop Bazaar collaboration and go straight into a commerce experience was really, really powerful and transformed what, you know, what would have been two disparate experiences on the consumer journey, and really kind of threads that needle. And I think it allowed us to kind of look at that content to commerce experience in a new way. We're really excited about it.
Yeah. Daz, you know, your best-selling book, Story Scraping, you talk a lot about mindset of a consumer and, you know, thinking about consumers in different worlds. And, you know, one of the things that we try to do at Flowcode and our whole mission is connecting the offline world to the digital world and a digital experience. Can you talk a little bit about the digital experiences that you're creating at Neiman Marcus? And it's one of the things that we're trying to do is facilitate these connections to those digital experiences.
Yeah, I think we're trying to build an entire ecosystem. And I think the quote I've often used is to stop making ads and start creating worlds is very true to what the world looks like today as a marketer. And things like Flowcode and our partnership with Hearst are part of that ecosystem that we're building out. For us, it's a really interesting dynamic is because we actually have physical environments. And beyond that, I always think of our physical environments, whilst they're lovely and we have inventory there, the most powerful thing we have there is actually our style advisors. So our innovation and digital ecosystem is enabling humans to interact with our customers in different and new ways, but also to fuel the interchange and engagement through content that can provide the inspiration. And I think that's the really exciting part as we start to build the more tentacles in that world, but then use innovation and technology to connect them to make them seamless so that the customer doesn't feel like it's hard work to move through that ecosystem. And along the way that they pick up little pieces of information they may choose to look for or find, or sometimes we can be a little disruptive in terms of inspiration and that sort of thing. So it's a combination of both building the equity of the engagement through the for the customer, but also looking at that distribution network for both content and product and thinking about the role each of those elements play for the customer. And that's a big part of our innovation, is to enable our people to connect with people and build the relationships that we are famous for historically, but also as our new customers evolve for their expectations to meet and exceed those expectations.
Yeah, and in certainly ever-evolving consumer landscape. You know, Kristen, I know one of the things that you and the team think about a lot about at Hearst is what is that reader experience, right? And what is it that you're trying to create? How can you meet their needs? Can you talk a little bit about some of the commerce experiences within content that you're also testing, and you know, how else are you able to fulfill reader expectations beyond the printed page?
Yeah, I mean, certainly the, you know, listen, I think we've all seen such a dramatic change, right, in consumer behavior in COVID, right? The quote of 2020 was probably we saw, you know, in the first 6 months of the pandemic, a greater shift in consumer behavior. And one of the largest ones was in e-commerce, right? And we had seen e-commerce growth in those first 6 months that we hadn't seen in the 10 years prior. And what's interesting is, you know, if you read earnings reports from lots of companies, that's a behavior that's here to stay. It doesn't mean that the physical environments are going away. And I think as Daz talks about kind of the in-store designers who are helping people kind of shop the store in ways that are meaningful to them, those experiences remain, but we can't argue what has happened, right, in e-commerce. And I'll say from Hearst's point of view, you know, what we saw through the pandemic was, you know, on the other side of it, we have an affiliate commerce business that's north of $1 billion, right? And commerce that's transacting within our content experiences, right? And when we looked at that spike in second quarter of 2020, you know, that wasn't an anomaly. What we see now in 2021 is that that is kind of the new norm, and that continues to grow for us. So this kind of content to commerce experience we know works. And if we look at it kind of from all angles of the parties, right, from the content creators, from the brands themselves, and even from consumers, I think if you look at content right now, if you have content that really does inspire action, you're a leading indicator for brands, right? They can get a lot of insight from what that consumer intent is from those content experiences. If you were, you know, a brand, you know, you want to get into that commerce, and commerce is lagging, but only ever so, you know, quickly behind, right, that intent from content. And so how you kind of unlock those experiences in real time is going to be critical. And I think smart companies have figured out there is a mix of both of those things, right? How do you get to be kind of integral to those inspiring content experiences that push consumers to action and get closer to the transaction at the same time, which is where, you know, a company like Neiman Marcus sits in a really interesting position kind of in that. And I think Daz had shared with me a stat at one point that even on their own website, when a consumer engages with a content experience, their cart is a lot bigger, right? So trusted brands and trusted content have an incredible ability to kind of pull consumers along that experience. So for us at Hearst, what that really means is, like, we have a lot of work to do to enhance the commerce experience of our content across the board. And for us, that means, how do we look more at direct affiliate partnerships, right, where the economics are better for us and specific partners? How do we look at building marketplaces? We talked about Shop Bazaar. That's really our first one in the luxury space. We're learning a lot as we go through that experience. And I think there's a lot of opportunity for these highly curated marketplace experiences, kind of curated by our editors and our luxury and fashion partners like Daz and his team. And it also is, how do we look at our entire content experience, and how do we make content more shoppable, whether that's making recipes more shoppable and easier and better ad experiences for our brand partners, or, you know, fashion and luxury through marketplaces, et cetera. So it's really reframing how we create inspiring content, but make a frictionless path to transaction for our audiences.
Yeah, I think what's been great to see your team take advantage of at Hearst is, this is not a Flowcode as a direct response tool, you know, putting a Flowcode onto an existing ad and dropping them onto a product description page. This is very much content driven, working closely with your editorial team, that edit team driving inspiration through the content. And Daz, you've talked a lot about shopping in an inspired state versus shopping in a utility or functional state, right? So can you expand a little bit on that?
Sure. I like to think of it as a spectrum. And at one end, you have the extreme functional needs. And then at the other end, I sort of proffer that we have that strange moment of the total random spontaneity when we just buy things, and sometimes we actually regret it a little later on because we didn't think it through. But in between there, to me, there's lots of stages of inspiration. And I think that, you know, even when you get to that random spontaneity, there's always something that triggers it. But each day I think about how we try to solve our functional needs. And I often talk as a guy in our shopping world is, you know, I need some new shirts. It's not a really big thing. I know what size I am. It's color's the biggest thing I've got to make a choice of. And I'm probably going to get another pink shirt because they always come up really well on Zoom. So things like that. But then there's the journey through the world of interaction of different content that we consume every day, that really is about inspiration. So sometimes the content's like a reminder, you need a new shirt. And then at other times it's connecting to people's curiosity or desire or interest, and the content shapes new possibilities. And the commerce role in that world to me is about creating a story journey that's connected. It should still be seamless, but it isn't driven by less clicks and speed. It's driven by helping the customer go through a narrated journey of little moments of inspiration and aspiration. Now, that could be how to think about how you might use a scarf differently, in a simple sense, or how to put together a new look for the new season, or what you need to take when you're traveling, and many other occasions. So in our business model, we try and think about that journey across the spectrum, but also across the boundaries of digital and physical. And I think it's interesting that all our conversation here, none of us are talking about e-commerce or digital content. It's universal today. And I think that's the important thing to recognize, is that there are, you know, connected pathways that customers think through. Our e-commerce evolution has been e-commerce engagement before purchasing in store for many customers, or e-commerce engagement before purchasing virtually with a style advisor using a text message. Those models of commerce didn't exist a couple of years ago, and I think they are definitely here to stay, and I think we will continually make them more useful, but also more inspiring for our customers when we think about the different needs we have.
Yeah, and in-store, Daz, what are some of the changes that you're considering and adding to make that digital to physical connection more easy in-store?
I think there's a variety of things. Sometimes it's taking the store to customers and not making it defined by a geographical location. And we can do that through different events or engagement and experiences for customers, but also creating environments where there's connected logic between what customers may have experienced digitally in a different environment. And even to our events. And, you know, we just recently did our holiday launch, and Jim, you're probably not aware of this, we used flow codes in physical environments where we didn't want to use words to tell stories. And, you know, literally of our 200 odd guests, I would say about 40% of them actually used a QR code to engage with richer, deeper content that enabled them to pick up information where we could make a better experience and environment for them, because we didn't have to put a lot of words and things in place. We could use technology to do that for us and make the content rich.
That's a great use case, really great use case. And Kristen, you know, consumer landscape, you've already mentioned it, right? We know that there are things that have come out of the pandemic that will likely not go away. And the expectation from a consumer standpoint. So just as a final few words, just how Hearst is thinking about continuing to serve their readers, their audiences, from a consumer standpoint.
I think, you know, it goes a lot to what Daz said, but it is about creating exceptional consumer experiences, and regardless of where that is happening. So certainly the huge shift, you know, in consumer was, you know, behaviors change dramatically from COVID. Some will stick, some won't. We think we know the ones, you know, that will, but the future, you know, remains to be seen. But for, as a media partner and a content provider, I think, you know, as we look at the world, the biggest shift, right, over whether it's through the pandemic or the last couple of years, it's from being kind of an inventory provider, right, to a strategic partner that actually helps our clients and brand partners solve their business challenges. And, you know, at Hearst, I do feel we're in a unique position based on, you know, the lens we have and that connection of content, commerce, and data that can help partners like Daz go from kind of insight from the beginning of when they're conceiving something all the way through to action with consumer. And that really is kind of the fun part of the job, right? That's like, we love solving problems and, you know, building these partnerships.
Terrific. And Daz, you know, on the consumer side for you, you've already mentioned really trying to create these worlds, these inspired states. Anything you want to preview for the holiday season on behalf of Neiman Marcus?
Well, I think it's kicked off, really, really well. I think customers should be thinking about shopping early and, you know, rewarding and recognizing all their loved ones that they haven't spent time with over the last year, and make sure your house is looking absolutely awesome for those occasions. But I'm looking forward to a fantastic holiday like everyone.
Terrific. Well, thanks to you both. This has been a great session. At Flowcode, we really appreciate the partnership. We look forward to doing much more. And dare I say, I hope not too early, but happy holidays to you both. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Jim. And great to see you, Daz. Take care, guys.
Thanks,
thank you.
Bye.